Today I'm going to explain you about three topics: upsampling, downsampling, sampling rate conversion by rational factor I by D, from the subject of digital signal processing from the unit of multi-rate signal processing. First of all, what is multi-rate signal processing and what is the basic requirement of this multi-rate signal processing? So, multi-rate signal processing will basically use in the digital signal processing. In this, there are basically two types of processing. The first one is analog domain signal processing and digital domain signal processing. So, before going through this, we'll starting with multi-rate processing. Now, what is the meaning of multi-rate processing? As you know that in the real world, we are using the original signal in the form of analog, and nowadays the advantages of digital signals are more. So we'll use in any method, we'll use the digital signal processor, right? So first of all, if we'll use the digital signal processor, it will process only on the digital signals. So first of all, we have to convert this analog signal into digital signal. So for that, we have to use A to D converter. So before this A to D converter, we have to use sampling, and thus in the sampling, we will set in some particular sampling rate. Same way, at the receiver side, we have to convert the digital signal into the original form. So for that, we will convert the digital signal to analog by using D2A converter. So for that also, we have to use some sampling rate. So if we use in any system as same sampling rate, then it will consider as a simple processing method. But if we use more than one sampling rate, means at the transmitter side we'll use the different sampling rate, at the receiver side also we'll use sampling rate is different, then this kind of processing is considered as multi-rate signal processing. So in any application, there is a requirement of more than one sampling rate, so we'll use the multi-rate signal processing. So in this, basically there are two types of signal processing. The first one is analog domain signal processing and the second one is digital domain signal processing. So starting with this analog domain signal processing, if we taking the analog domain signal processing, in this the domain will be analog, means suppose if you want to do the filtering, then for this filtering we will use this filter which is in the form of analog. So suppose if the original information signal is in the form of digital, then we have to convert, first of all we have to convert it in the analog form, and then for that we will use the D2A converter. So for that we have to apply some sampling rate. Suppose if we are applying sampling rate A at the input side, same way this analog output is given to the filter, it will filter out the particular frequency or particular thing, and then it will give you the output in the A to D converter. So it will convert the analog signal in back to the digital output. But for this A to D converter, suppose if we use the different sampling rate, like new sampling rate D, then in this whole process, as we have used two different sampling rates, so this kind of processing is considered as multi-rate signal processing. In this, we had used this filter in the analog form, so this domain is considered as analog domain signal processing. But we can also use the digital domain signal processing for this. So if we are applying the digital domain signal processing, so for that there is no requirement of this D2A or A to D converter, and we'll directly use the digital domain to convert any original signal into the required format. Now if we're taking the advantages of analog domain signal processing, the first advantage is it can select any sampling rate because there is no relationship between old sampling rate. So you can see that we can set any sampling rate A and B. There is no relationship between this two different sampling rate A and B. So we can select any sampling rate because there is no relationship between this two sampling rate. Now there are some disadvantages of analog domain signal processing. The first disadvantage is, while we are converting digital signal in terms of analog, for that we will use the D2A converter, it will introduce some distortion in the signal rebuilding. So because of it, it will give you the distortion in the output, and A to D converter also gives you the quantization error. So at the transmitter at the as well as at the receiver side, it will introduce some errors because of it will can't get the original signal properly at the receiver side. So for that, for this reason, we'll use the digital domain signal processing. So if we're using this digital domain signal processing, in this there will be basically two operations. The first one is decimation and the second one is interpolation. Decimation is also considered as downsampling and interpolation is considered as upsampling. So we'll directly converting the original digital signal into the upsample or downsample version by using this digital domain signal processing. Now the next point is applications of multi-rate signal processing. What are the applications of this multi-rate signal processing? The first one is speech processing. In the speech processing, at any moment of time, we can change the value of sampling rate of it. So for that, we use this multi-rate signal processing. In the audio signal processing also, we use this multi-rate signal processing, or in high quality data acquisition system, or in the narrow band filtering, we will use this multi-rate signal processing. And at last, the next point is transmultiplexers. In the transmultiplexers, we will use this multi-rate signal processing. Transmultiplexers means we convert it in another form. So in this also, we will use the more than one sampling rate, means we will use the multi-rate signal processing. Now the next topic is downsampling or decimation by a factor of B, means we will reduce the number of samples. So starting with this, if I am taking suppose any input x, which is a function of n, means number of samples n, and if I am taking this is a 2, 1, minus 1, 1 and 2. Suppose if I am making this as the original information signal, then we have to convert it into number of samples, which is reduced by a factor of some factor d. Like suppose if I am taking the value of d equals to 2, means we have to reduce the number of samples by a factor of 2. Means for that we will be removing the 1-1 sample from this. So if we are removing 1-1 sample, then it will consider as x of, if we are taking it as x of 2n, then because of this 2, we have to divide by this 2. If I am dividing this by a factor of 2, then 0 divided by 2 means 0. On the 0, its value is 2. On 1, 1 divided by 2 means it will be considered as 1 by 2. And as you know that 1 by 2 sample is not possible, so we will be discarding this particular sample. Now this 2 divided by 2 means 1. On the value of 1, we will getting the amplitude equals to minus 1. Same way, 3 divided by 2 means 1.5, so it will not possible, so we will be moving or we will discarding this particular sample. And the last one is 4. 4 divided by 2 means 2. So on 2, its value is 2. So this way, we will deriving this factor. So this will be considered as x of n into b. B means decimation factor. So here we have taken decimation factor as b equals to 2. So you can see that in this number of samples are more, we'll converting it into less number of samples. It means we'll downsampling the term. In this we had removed d minus 1 terms. So d minus 1 means 2 minus 1. So every 1-1 sample will be removed. One sample we had taken, next sample is removed. Next sample we had taken, next sample is removed. Right. So this way we can derive the downsampling by a process of decimation. So basically, if I am defining this downsampling, then what is downsampling? It is the process in which sampling rate is reduced. So if we are drawing the block diagram of this, then the block diagram will be like this. Input x of n is given to this downsampler, which will be do the downsampling by a factor of d. So it will give you the output y of n equals to x of n into d. Here, as we have taken d equals to 2, right? Now in this, there will be aliasing effect is occur because this particular input signal is converted into less number of samples, right? So this will be compressed, get compressed into less number of samples by using down sampling. So you can see that because of compression, it will give you the overlapping of the terms. So it will give you the aliasing effect. As you know that if we are reducing the sampling rate, then it will give you the aliasing effect. So we will use this particular thing over here. So the aliasing effect is occur because we had reduced the number of samples. So if we want to remove this aliasing effect, then we have to use pre-alias filter. So before applying any input signal to the sampler, we will use the pre-aliasing filter. So suppose if I am using this down sampler, so before that we will use this pre-alias filter. Okay, so original information signal x of n is given to pre-aliasing filter. So it will select a particular region, then it will give to the down sampler. So it will give you the output y of n, which is down sampled by input x of n by a factor of n. So in the down sampler, we will use filter before applying it to the down sampler. So if we draw the diagram, for this, then the diagram will be like this. Before applying input signal to this decimeter, we'll apply it to the filter, and the filter response is h of n. So x of n is given to this filter, it will give you the output as a p of n, it will be down sampled, it will give you the output as a y of n. So it will be decimated by a factor of b. Now the next topic is upsampling or interpolation by a factor of I. So it is a process in which we will increasing the sampling rate. So number of samples will be increased. Suppose if you want to increase the number of samples, then the term will be x of n divided by something, right? So if I want to increase by a factor of 2, then n divided by 2. So divide by 2 means multiply by 2. So we can representing this. This 1 into 2 means 2. On 2, its value equals to 1, right? So this way we can expanding the original information signal, right? In this, middle term will be considered as 0, and according to that it will be in the stretch form. So if I am drawing this interpolation process will consider as interpolation means upsample by a factor of I, then this term will be representing as x of n divided by n. So if I am applying input signal as x of n, so it will give you the output y of n as y of n equals to x of n divided by n. In this, you can see that we had insert the zeros because there is no value. So if we insert the zeros, so because of it, it will give you the images. So this kind of images is considered as one kind of noise. So if you want to remove this noise, so for that we have to use anti-imaging filter. So the next term is anti-imaging filter. If we use the anti-imaging filter, then we can remove these images. But where we will use this anti-imaging filter? First, images will occur, then we will remove these images, right? So first of all, because of this upsampling, it will introduces the images. Now this images can be removed by this anti-imaging filter, right? So it will give you the output proper. So in the interpolation process, we'll apply the output of interpolation to this filter. So in this process, we'll apply the filter at the output set, and in the decimation process, we'll apply the original information signal to the filter. So filter is applied before this decimation process, right? Now if we want to convert the sampling rate by a rational factor, means I by D, then how will do the sampling rate conversion? Suppose if I am taking 4 by 3, means we have to do down sampling by a factor of 3 and up sampling by a factor of 4. Then what will be the value x of, if you want to find out x of 4 by 3 into n, then we have to do 3 down sample, means we have to remove 2 samples and we have to add 3 samples, right? Now in this process, which process will occur in first? Means first of all we have to do up sampling and then down sampling, or first of all we have to do down sampling and up sampling. So for that, if I am drawing this down sampler, Then as you know that in the downsampler, before applying to it, we will apply it to the anti-aliasing filter, right? So this one is downsampler, this one is exophyne, this one is cryophyne. And same way, if I am applying to the upsampler, in this we had used the filter at the output side. Right, so this one is exophyne, then this one is cryophyne. So in this, we will use the filter at the output side. So if I am merging this two thing, means suppose if I am applying first to the downsampler and then this upsampler, then this will be look like this. It means we have to use this two filters, and if I am using this as a frequency, suppose FS, sampling frequency FS, it will change over here. It will be considered as FS. It will be divided downsample by a factor of D. Means it will consider as FS by D. This one is FS by D, so this will be considered as FS into I divided by D. And over here the term is FS I divided by D. Means we have to use two different filter with two different frequencies, right? So for this particular arrangement, we have to use two different filter with two different frequencies. Now if we use first as upsampler, then upsampler's output is given to the anti-imaging filter. Output of it is given to the anti-aliasing filter and output of it is given to the downsampler. Suppose if I am using this at last, right? So in this you can see that suppose if I am applying FS as an input, then the frequency will be increased by I, its value will remain same, its value will remain same, and this will be downsampled by a factor of D, right? So in this you can see that this two filter with the same frequency FS input. So we can merge these two filters, so we'll use only one filter when it will use the interpolation process. At this moment it will work as anti-imaging filter, and if we use the decimation process at this moment, this will work as the anti-aliasing filter. So it will give you the proper output with only one filter. So basically in the sampling rate conversion by a rational factor, we will use this particular arrangement. It means first of all we will increase the number of samples by a factor of I, then we will reduce the number of samples by a factor of D. It means first of all we will do the interpolation process and then we will do the decimation process. Thank you so much.